Hello everyone, in this video we're going to install a lot of cooling parts on the Corvette. We'll start with an upgraded Mishimoto radiator that we have right here. Of course we're gonna have to change the coolant, so we'll use Dex Cool and water. It's a 40% coolant, 60% water mix from what I saw in the manual, so that's what I'm going to use. While we're it, we're gonna change the thermostat. I did order this 194 degree motor thermostat, but actually from what I see on the thermostat it's 207 degrees, and it's a GM original part, so not exactly what I ordered, but I think it's good and I will use this. And I'll also install the GM performance kit, which is an auxiliary radiator or the C7 Corvette right there with all the pipings. Okay, let's get started. Okay, I jacked up the car. For the first part, we're going to remove this plastic. For that, we need to remove these four bolts. Those are four 10 millimeter bolts. And these bolts, these are six bolts. I think they are 7 millimeter, and then we'll be able to remove this plastic between these two brackets. Bolts have been removed. Now we'll have access to the space where we need to install the kit. I do not have the cutting pattern, so I'm trying to make one on my own. For start, I have cut this piece of rough paper exactly in the area that needs cooling. So I will use that as a pattern. And I marked here where we should leave some space for this connector. So here I need 36 millimeters upwards, and I have marked the margins, and here 47 millimeters, and also I have marked the margins. Now of course this is how it's gonna be installed on the car, so actually I had to move over the markings on the other side. Beside that, I just have to make sure that we have another 70 millimeters on the sides, and 1.5 or 15 millimeters here. Using this homemade pattern, I have made a quick draw to see where it goes. I have marked the pattern margins, and also here where we need to cut out space for those two pipings. So what I was paying attention for, let me remove this. Not sure if the pattern is somewhat visible. I drew it with the pen, but yeah, so I pay attention to these margins to make sure it's aligned with this and with this on the other side, and also to make sure that I have at least 20 millimeters here and here. And I drilled some small holes. Of course I will enlarge them, but I did some small holes just to see on the other side where it comes out, to make sure that I like the position of this radiator where it comes. Okay, so now next I will enlarge the holes and cut it out with my cutting tool that I have. Now initially I thought that we're not going to need to cut this two spots out for the pipes, but because this is not straight and it's actually curved, yeah, like this, it will hit the pipes. So that's why we need to cut this out. Okay, so I installed this adapter on my electric impact gun, but I'll use it slowly just to enlarge the hole. That's it. Do the same for all of them, then start cutting. You know, I will start cutting with my cutting tool, starting from the holes that I drilled, following the pattern that I draw, and see if my measurements were correct. Here it is how it turned out. Now I will do a test fit and see if it's okay. Okay, I'm pretty pleased with how it turns out. Only need to do some small adjustments right here, around this fitting and here where it touches the radiator, and other than that, let's say it's pretty good. Yeah. Now for these little brackets that come installed, that should be installed right here, I will add some glue and fix them in place while I will install the radiator, because it's just silly to remove the entire front bumper just because you can't hold this in place while installing. So that's what I'm gonna do. By the way, I drilled these holes while test fitting the radiator bracket, and that's how I drilled them, so should be easy enough to get it done. This is the glue that I'm going to use on this bracket. I'll just apply some right here and then fix them up on the inside where the two holes are, yeah, like this, and then it will make it really easy to fit the radiator. Okay, that's right there. I'm gonna install it. Okay, there you go. So the bracket is now fixed in place with some glue and ready to install. This is the foam seal. This foam seal comes right here over the holes that we made, and in order to fit it up, I drilled these holes simply by moving the foam here underneath and marking the holes and drilling, and then just fit. Okay, so I added the clips right here for the foam. And now with the foam fix and with this bracket, not sure if they're visible, but yeah, those brackets right there. With these brackets that are glued in, we should be able to finally fit our radiator. Okay, for the final part I just had to install these four bolts, I mean two here and two here. It was pretty easy because the brackets were in place, like glued. That's how it turned out. Let's have a look from the outside. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with the result. I think it looks good and it will work great. Next we're going to flush the coolant from the system. For that I will start by opening up the cap just so it can take some air, and hopefully it will flush quicker and open. Open the drain plug. So this is the drain plug that we open. While the coolant is draining, we make some more space here because we're also going to change the radiator, and we start by removing this plastic. That means removing this bolt, that one, this one, and the one from the other side. And after this plastic is out, we will also remove this intake pipe. Okay, we've removed that plastic. Now we're gonna tackle this intake pipe by unbolting this bolt and this bolt. And also I have removed these two hoses simply by pressing on this gray area right here and removing. Same here, and after that we're gonna take out this part as well. Okay, so the intake pipe is now removed. I did notice that I had some oil here that I cleaned up. I will also clean up those marks, and I also noticed I have this problem with the wiring where it is just cracking to pieces, so I'll have to fix that as well before putting everything back together. Now I will remove the thermostat right here. It has three bolts, and here I think they are 10 millimeter bolts. I will remove and see if that helps with draining the coolant. If not, no problem. We're gonna change it anyway. Okay, the bolts are removed from the thermostat, so now I have moved this clamp from here to here just using my simple tool. And now I also moved this clamp, which is a bigger one, lower, so I can remove the thermostat. I'll use this. And while we're at it, I think I will also remove this plastic so I can clean up the air filter. I have a can and air filter, so cleaning will do. For that I remove these bolts right here, and I have already removed this red safety thing right here. Now I will push it and remove the sensor, and yeah, then we're gonna have even more space. Okay, the thermostat is out. However, I think this is a very old thermostat, probably the one with the car. This seal is stuck right here, so I will have to undo it and clean it up nicely. Also, it was stuck in this holes. I had to rotate it a few times to make sure it gets loose. Now up next here is the cable that goes to the fan that I have removed by pressing and pulling it out. Next I will undo these two holes, these two bolts here and here. Yeah, and Then I will try to remove the fan. Okay, so I removed those two bolts, however the fan still doesn't, I mean it comes loose, but I can't remove it. It still has these two places where it's being tied up to this hose. I'm not sure how that is being removed, so I will remove this clamp. Here, so I will untie this hose from the radiator, then I can lift it upwards and see how we can undo this part. I figured it out eventually, so you have to remove these three clamps, 1, 2, 3, because otherwise the fan will not come loose and you cannot remove it. After removing these three clamps and the bolts, it came off. Okay, next I'm going to remove all the hoses connecting to the radiator, starting with this one on top, this one right here, that one, and that one. So there are four hoses in total, and then I look to what's next. All the hoses are disconnected now, so I will remove this bolt and this one. Those are the only two bolts left that hold the radiator in place, and then we'll try to remove it. I was able to remove the radiator finally, but it was quite a pain because of these clamps. The air conditioning radiator and cooling radiator are being held together by these very annoying clamps. And in order to separate, I had to lift this one, lower the other radiator and separate here. So yeah, pretty annoying, and I think I did bend it a little right here while trying to lift it up, unfortunately. But yeah, it's out. These are the clamps where the air conditioning radiator slides in, both sides. They're also here on the bottom. So when you are trying to remove it, you actually can't, because it's being held by the air conditioning radiator, and you have to lift it, and while lifting it you also have to push this safety plastic in, and that makes it pretty difficult from that position. But okay, it's out. We'll have a quick comparison with the Mishimoto radiator and put it back in. Here's the difference between the Mishimoto radiator and the original one. If we have a look to the thickness, yeah, it's a much thicker radiator. Okay, on the Mishimoto radiator there is only one clamp right here on the bottom that is being used to install the casing radiator instead of the four that were on the original radiator, so that's easy to install. And I had to move over this boot right here, this boot from the other radiator. Okay, and now I will try to put it back in place. Okay, here it is, and just put it in place. One important thing to check if everything sits all right here, like this plastic comes above, is to check if the bolts, those bolts, are actually in its place. Right, like here, it's test control and it looks in place. Also on the other side. So, okay, we're good. Okay, so I made some adjustments. I centered the radiator, make sure it goes all the way in, meaning this plastic is coming up a little bit over the radiator, so the fitment should be nice and flush. Also the air conditioning radiator, which is in front, has to be centered, otherwise this will not go in. Okay, next I will remove this hose. This comes from the heat exchanger and it was going here, the radiator, but I will remove it because now it'll add new hoses that will go to the auxiliary radiator in the front, and then it will come here. So that's what I'm gonna do next. I have removed these two clamps and this $50 hose, $50 connector from the hose using my tool, and I'll move them to the other hose. Okay, using the hoses and this thermic protections, I think, from the kit, I have made the new hoses. I cut them, measured and cut them. This side is going to the heat exchanger pipe. I have reused the clamp. This side is going to the radiator. I have also reused the clamp and this fitting, the GM fitting. Now on the other side I will just use the other clamps that came with the kit. Let's put them on. Okay, it's getting dark, but here are the fittings. So again, this one, the first one, hold on. Okay, so the first one, this one goes to the radiator, and the second one is the one returning from the heat exchanger. Okay, I put back the hoses, this hose, the big one, the other hose right there, and this one that goes to the coolant reservoir. Now the only thing what's left to do is to install the thermostat that I have here. However, I'm thinking that I will actually fill the system with coolant through this hose. I'll keep it on top of everything right here, and when this will be full, maybe we'll see coolant here as well. Then I will just mock the thermostat, put it in place, put back the thermostat clamps, and then fill the rest of the system from the coolant reservoir. This way I think I'm gonna add as much coolant as possible in the system for now. Okay, so I added 3 liters of water, is distilled water, to prepare the coolant, and to that I will add 2 liters of Dex Cool, and that way we're gonna have 40% coolant, 60% water mix, and then we'll use it in the system. Okay, so 3 liters water, 2 liters of desk cool, we have 5 liters of coolant. Okay, I filled the system with coolant. I added coolant in these holes as much as I could until it came out where the thermostat is now. And then I installed the thermostat by putting back these 3 bolts and put back the hoses. And for the rest of the coolant, I simply added it through the normal place. Now we're going to put back the fan and connect it. Okay, so I give it a good clean to the fan. Now don't forget, while installing, we're gonna be paying attention to a few things. Like putting back right here the connectors, and here will be the connector for the cable that provides power to the fan. So 3 connectors, power, and make sure this clamp is aligned with the one from the Mishimoto radiator. Okay, the fan is back in its position. Here is the bolt. There is a similar bolt on the other side that holds it in place. Also, you have to make sure right there that it will here, that it will slide right into the aluminium support that it has. And then make sure to put back these clamps. It's one here, one there for the cable, and of course the don't forget the power cable. Without the power cable, it will not work. Also, we did a quick cleanup on the air filter before putting it back. Of course, using the K&M products, it's a K&M filter. While we're it making sure that it's nice and clean. Okay, put back the air filter. It's 2 bolts right here, T25 bolts. Of course, I cleaned the air filter that I showed earlier and put it back in here, and wired back the sensor. Not sure if it's some airflow or temperature sensor, but it's some kind of sensor. I think it's airflow, so put it back here. Now I have to fix this unexpected problem that I have with these wires. Seems like your protection is all cracked up, so I just use some tape that I have and fix it. Okay, I put back in position the intake pipe and I tightened down these 2 bolts to the to those hoses, and put back these 2 clamps that come right here. And only thing left then is this plastic vent. Up the car to have the coolant running a little bit through the radiator and everything. And meanwhile, I noticed that this pipe right here, because now the radiator is bigger and comes backwards a little bit more, it is touching the alternator pulley. Actually I noticed it a little bit late and not touched it for a while, but I'll need to find a solution for that and then it should be good. Okay, in order to fix this problem with the pipe touching the alternator pulley right here, I noticed that the problem is this won't sit in its place, and if we're able to fix it like right here, then it will have enough space. So for that I have made this aluminium piece. This actually is from the Mishimoto radiator kit. I'm not sure what actually was its purpose, but I bent it, so I put it right here and fix it on that bolt from the air filter like that, and then I'll I'll put back the bolt and I think it will hold it down. Okay, I put back the bolt and this aluminium piece that I have made. Now there is some space, but I think it's holding the pipe pretty good, and here we have enough clearance not to touch the pulley. Yeah, I think I just have to put back the plastic vent and we're done. Okay, the plastic vent is back. I had to use here some inox bolts, I think they are stainless steel bolts. I think they were in the Mishimoto kit because those ones did not fit, and with this in place, this now clearing here, I think we're done. Nothing else left to do. Thank you.